This is SportsCenter 5 2-Minute Drill.
Part of playing in the NFL is putting your body on the line. It's normalizing broken bones and torn ligaments. But ex-NFL players didn't sign up to have their race used against them to normalize dementia or CTE due to years of playing the game without the warning that it could lead to cognitive decline. The NFL engaged in something called race norming. The practice set a lower cognitive baseline for black ex-NFL players and the testing used to determine cognitive issues. The NFL claiming that race and socioeconomic background predisposed some of the black players to be less mentally capable than their white counterparts. Of course, that made it much harder for black players to prove the threshold of decline that would compel the NFL to pay them via a class action concussion settlement. In fact, the NFL got several claims overturned on the basis of race norming. That's despicable. Thankfully, this practice was scrapped as lawyers for the league and former NFL players agreed to a joint proposal to end it last week. This comes after two black ex-players sued the league for discrimination and how it was handing out the money from the settlement, which has paid out more than $800 million, according to the New York Times. Let's get something straight. There's nothing normal about dementia. There's nothing normal about CTE. There's nothing normal about discriminating against your former employees. And this was naked discrimination by the NFL, using stereotypes about the black men who helped build their brand and boost the value of their franchises to deny them help. It just shows you that the NFL sees them as disposable razors. You throw one away when it gets dull, you just plug in the next one until it too is exhausted. Lawyers for the black players suspect that white men were qualifying for these awards at two or three times the rate of blacks since the payouts began in 2017. So why would the NFL do this? Well, the NFL is 70% black and 60% of its living retirees are also African American. It's great that NFL owners are donating money to social justice causes, allowing messages of equality on helmets and on the field, but frankly, it's sanctimonious if they're weaponizing the type of medical discrimination that black folks have dealt with for years to prevent ex-players from receiving the help and the funds they need after the cheers and the NFL paychecks dry up. Race norming is the ultimate illegal procedure by the NFL, and the ones being penalized are the black men who gave their bodies and their minds to feed the professional football beast. That's the 2-Minute Drill.